Hello students, how are you? Hope you are safe. So today I am going to continue with my same lesson, that is in economics, introduction to economics. So who is the father of economics? I already said you, that is Adam Smith is called as father of the economics. So already I have completed two classes of this introduction to economics. And today my topic is economic activities. So under that there are four points, that is production, consumption, exchange and distribution. So first let me give the meaning of the economic activities. Most of the goods and services that we use every day are limited in supply. Limited means what? There are shortage in supply. Why? Because the population is more and each and every good they have to produce in more quantity, and hence they are not available free of cost, because for each and everything we need to purchase. Even a safety pin also is not free of cost. We need to purchase them. That is called as an economy. And these goods and services are called economic goods and services. Goods means what we are using day to day life. Those are called as an goods. That is grains, it may be clothes, it may be mobiles, it may be so many garments. So whatever the things, those are called as goods. Services like education, doctor, nurse, engineer. So these are become under the services. We are buying them. Yes or no? We are not getting free of cost. And we use our skills and labors to earn money. So to earn money, what we are doing? Day and night we are working. We'll get the earning. Without earned money, what a man is doing? He is satisfying his want. And satisfying his want by using that money, what he earned, is called as an economic activity. And the economic activity can be classified into four kinds, that is production, consumption, exchange and distribution. So these are the things that today I am going to explain. So now production. So production means what? Manufacturing the goods and services is called as a production. Production activities are those that produce goods and services. Now for example, like agricultural produce, those are the grains. Why we need food? Why we need food? To be healthy. Yes or no? We get from the food, we'll get the proteins, calciums, vitamins, minerals, and also to be strong, to lead a life, we need a food. Agriculture, animal husbandry. From that what we get, milk and the meat. Fishery, fishing, mining means what? For the sake of fossil fuels like petroleum, diesel, kerosene, minerals, what are those? So these are all we get from the mining. And the forest development, like no cutting the trees and all, we need to grow the plants and all. And different kinds of industries are there that produce the goods. And transportation also we need, communication we need, so etc. So these are all we come under the production. So production is what? Producing the, manufacturing the goods and services. For whom sake we manufacture the goods and services? For the sake of the consumption, the customers, the consumption, to satisfy our wants. And next one, that is a consumption. So the people, the consumers, what they will do? They will buy the things and they will satisfy their wants. So each and every want is very important. We need clothes, we need food, we need shelter, we need a house. So for each and everything there is a manufacturing department rather that produce the things, and we the people will buy and will satisfy our wants. And all automobiles, industries are there, mobiles are there. So each and everything, each and every good we need. And goods and services are produced for whom sake? For the sake of the consumption only. And man, what he will do? He will satisfy his wants by buying goods and services. So all these activities are known as a consumption activities. So the next one, that is an exchange. Here the exchange is nothing but the producer, what he will do after manufacturing the goods and all, he won't keep on himself, he will send to the market. That is called as an exchange. So the producer, he will exchange, he will send his goods to the market where the shopkeepers will keep in their shop. We the consumers, what you do, will go and will buy the things. So here what it takes place, the selling and buying takes place. That is called as the producers produce goods for the consumers. There is a marketing system to supply the produced goods to the consumers where selling and buying takes place. And the next one, that is a distribution. So the income, the distribution is nothing but the income that is earned through production of goods has to be distributed to the various factors of production, that is land, labor, capital, and business, and sometimes many activities which are not economic in nature becomes the economic activity. Now for example, like a teacher, a doctor it may be. Now a teacher, when she render her service free of cost, when she own charge money, that is called as an economic activity. When the same service she'll charge the money, fees, that is it will become an economic activity. Even our doctor also, when he give his service free of cost, not called as an economic activity. When he charge fees, that is called as an economic activity. So today I will explain you all about the production, consumption, exchange and the distribution. So tomorrow again I'm going to continue with my same lesson. I hope you are understanding my explanation, students. So tomorrow I'm going to continue. Thank you.